imagine that concept, or was there a specific statement or message or idea that you were looking for a concept to articulate?
Bueno, realmente no se me ocurre a mí. Es un guión que parte de una obra de teatro que nunca se hizo, que lo escribió David de Solá junto con Pedro Rivero.
Use the mic.
Sorry, well, yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, so originally it was not my idea. It was a script for a play done by David de Solá and Pedro Rivero, and it was never played.
They never put on the performance. They never did the production of the play. Is that what you said?
No.
And so, how did you come across the script? Like, did you just stumble upon it, or was it introduced to you?
Son guionistas que conocemos y de alguna manera le llegó a Carlos, que es el productor que está ahí, y quedó cautivado con la primera lectura. Evidentemente no se parecía mucho a lo que acabáis de ver, era una obra teatral.
We know each other, and actually the script, Carlos got it and was fascinated by it, by the first read.
And what I was also interested about the film is how there's so much ambiguity to the script. Did the script provide that detail? Was that something, or that lack of detail, that ambiguity, was that something that you intentionally wanted to preserve in the film, where you don't quite know what the administration represents, or you leave that up to the audience's imagination and interpretation?
Antes, una cosita solo. Los guionistas, los habéis visto en la película, son los dos que salen en la bañera.
Okay, so just in case, if you know, the two scriptwriters are the ones that are showing on the bathtub.
Oh, the bathtub. Those are the writers.
And the question, let me try to see if I can remember, the ambiguity of this film was because of the script lack of detail, or you wanted it was intentional for the audience to get that?
Sorry. It's okay.
Okay, let me do that again.
Sí, efectivamente, nosotros no queríamos soltar un panfleto, no queremos adoctrinar a nadie, lo que hemos querido siempre es exponer un problema y que cada uno vea un poco cuál es su visión de lo que debe hacer. Esta película no va de cambiar el mundo, esta película va de cambiarse a uno mismo. Esta película apela a la solidaridad que puede ejercer cada uno. ¿Qué hacemos cada uno de nosotros en cada situación, si estamos en el nivel 200 o si estamos en el nivel 6?
Yes, that is right. It's actually to expose the issue and what we have as each other of our vision. We're not trying to change the world here. We're exposing solidarity and what do we do? You know, how we question each other on what to do in these sort of circumstances. Either we are level 200 or level 0.
And the other question before I throw it to the audience is just the production design is so magnificent, and I also think very inspiring to a filmmaker who might feel like, oh, I don't have the resources to do something with an ambitious scope, but it seems to me that you built one set, and I want to know if that is correct. If you built one set and you simply just redress it for every level.
Yes. Sí. Tenemos un guión muy teatral. Entonces, cuando llegó a nuestras manos, mi obsesión fue convertirlo en algo mucho más físico, algo más cinematográfico y algo que fuera más asumible para un público más de cine que de teatro. Era una película muy ideológica, muy de diálogos y apenas había nada físico.
First part of the answer coming up.
Well, yes, since it was a script meant for the theater, we needed to make it more physical and more towards the movie. Since the script, there was a lot of lines spoken, we wanted to make that ideology into more of a, for the movie, becoming as a movie.
Y claro, para eso necesitábamos construir un hoyo con un aspecto muy real y muy alejado del teatro. Entonces, evidentemente ese sitio no existe y lo construimos.
Another part of the question.
And so we built the set, we wanted to make it real, very real and very far from the theater, from a play. So we had to do it ourselves.
Y efectivamente construimos dos niveles. Construimos dos niveles y una pequeña parte abajo para poder poner la plataforma, una grúa que llevará la plataforma. Cuando rodábamos hacia arriba, lo hacíamos desde el nivel de abajo, y cuando rodábamos hacia y mirábamos hacia abajo, nos subíamos al nivel de arriba.
So we built two levels, and we had a little one below, so we could do and build the platform. So when the platform was going up, we were doing the camera from below all the way up, and vice versa when the platform was going down.
Who is your chef on the film?
Bueno, la mayoría de los planos detalles son mis manos. Sí, la mayoría, sí. Los caracoles son mis manos.
Like the snail scene, there are my hands. Most of the details are my hands.
Oh, wow. Right. Master chef, master filmmaker. Do we have questions in the audience? Yes, right there, first. Oh, you next, sorry, yeah. Why was the word obviously used so much? I suppose that's a question for the writers, but that is very funny.
Isn't it obvious?
Isn't it obvious?
Bueno, a ver, David tiene una forma de escribir muy repetitiva y genera humor en este tipo de con este tipo de cuñas para dar personalidad a los personajes. Y sobre todo también para ver esta coletilla fue creada para que después uno del muerto Trimagasi Goren heredara esta palabra y se viera cómo esa mezquindad que representa Trimagasi se queda para siempre dentro de Goren.
Well, the screenwriter David actually has a way to repeat itself, to give a little bit of character or personality to the character. And when Trimagasi died, it was a way also to give a little bit of heritage to the lead, Goren.
Where he had come from and his past following him, yes. You, Shane, go ahead. Okay, so maybe to simplify it, the question is about, did the structure change from the script to the screen, and what motivated the casting for each role, I think were the two parts of that question.
Parte de un guión de teatro. Después fue un proceso muy tormentoso de escritura. Sí, no, pero claro, para saber cómo llegar a cada... la película está estructurada. Realmente la película se rige más por una narrativa emocional que una física que una narrativa física de los hechos. La cosa es navegar en esa emocionalidad que nos lleva hasta el final. Entonces, respondiendo a este objetivo, estructuramos los diferentes perfiles de personajes a lo largo de la película.
Okay, the script is an actual or complicated script. So we wanted to do an emotional narrative rather than physical. So in order to go into this goal is we try to be consequent to our casting for these profiles.
Y los criterios del casting, pues bueno, una vez que sabes qué perfil es, a qué tiene que responder cada personaje, pues es buscar la persona más adecuada. No, buscamos muchísimo. Es un proyecto muy pequeño en cuanto a dimensión de presupuesto, pero no en cuanto al trabajo. Hay muchísimo trabajo de muchísima gente, y una de las cosas que realmente trabajamos fue el casting y la búsqueda de los personajes, de los actores idóneos para interpretar cada personaje.
We did spend a lot of time on casting work. It is a small project when it comes to the budget perspective, but it is a very big project when it comes to the people and the talent. We did take a long time to pick the perfect profiles and the perfect characters and actors.
Right there. The significance of Don Quixote. Sorry, continue. Yeah. Was Don Quixote an element of the screenplay?
Esto, de hecho, al principio, en la primera versión del guión, estaba mucho más presente esto. Pues la presencia, o sea, la importancia es máxima. Al final, incluso veis que físicamente el protagonista cada vez se parece más a Don Quijote. Y es un caballero andante y es un luchador en busca de quimeras y de cosas imposibles que al final no sabemos si las conseguirá.
Actually, Don Quixote was more present than before. You can see along the movie that the lead actually resembles physically more and more. And it is a knight armor and a fighter, and we'll see if at the end.
And he has a Sancho Panza of it too. yes, right there. How many times did you have to re-prepare the feast?
Fueron 6 semanas de rodaje y rodábamos con la plataforma 18 días.
So it was a 6 week filming and we did it 18 days with the platform.
18 times you had to redo that feast, or that full feast, wow. More questions, right over there, yes. Been waiting for that one. What food would you pick for your menu? French fries. Right there.
Was there a reason why people changed levels?
Did anything motivate the, no.
It is
just life is cruel.
No, bueno, la película va un poco de eso, es cómo actuarías tú, no él, tú, si estuvieras en el nivel 6 o si estuvieras en el nivel 200. Porque es muy fácil ser solidario si estás en el 14 y puedes dejar pasar algo. Pero cómo actuarías cuando lo que tienes no es suficiente ni siquiera para ti mismo. Entonces la película va situando a los protagonistas en situaciones muy complicadas para ver cómo reaccionan en cada situación.
Well, it wasn't. That's the way basically the movie goes. It is asking you what you would do if you're on the level 6 or if you're on level 200. it's very easy to be so caring and solidarity with, if you are in a level 14, you can let it go for one day or two. But if you don't have enough for yourself, are you caring enough to give away? And that's what the lead characters were trying to go through complicated situations like these.
All right, thank you so much. I think we're gonna end it on that. Guys, don't forget, vote for the film. It's eligible for the Grown People's Choice Midnight Madness Awards. And excuse us, we're gonna enjoy some kind of power.
Thank you very much.